Deontay Wilder, Ali, Lenny Lewis. I be bringing him.
Bomb squad, bomb squad, bomb squad, squad up. Bomb squad, bomb squad, bomb squad, squad up. Bomb squad, bomb squad, bomb squad, squad up. Bomb squad, bomb squad, bomb squad, squad up.
Line 'em up,
we take 'em out.
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 All right, man. Peace and blessings. This is a quick update on the extent of the injuries of Deontay Wilder. They said when he went to the hospital immediately, it was just a cut inside his ear, which it did affect his equilibrium. He had to get a couple of stitches in his ear. Not many, but he had a few stitches, according to his trainer, JD, said that it was pretty much just about the extent of that far as his eardrum. And he kind of really downplayed the injury and saying that it wasn't really as big as people made it, but it did affect his equilibrium in that fight. And also, I want to touch on something, man. I'm gonna be real on this shit right here. I'm gonna have to contradict myself, cause you know I'm pretty sure y'all heard me say I'm all about fighters' safety and stuff like that. It's about safety first, and you don't want nobody getting hurt. I still feel that way and all that, but man, when you're the champ, you got to let the man go out on his shield. I'm going to have to say different for this fight. This is our champion, Deontay Wilder. He's still our champion. I felt like he had an opportunity to come back in that fight. It was just the seventh round, and I feel like he did have an opportunity. I mean, when your equilibrium shot, it's something different, man. I will say that. You know, you discombobulated. Your body can't react the way your mind is. Things of that nature, but you can recover. And with the power that the Bronze Bomber have, I still felt like he had an opportunity. And if he didn't, I mean, if he was going to get beat from pillar to post for the duration of the fight, then he would have just had to get beat from pillar to post for the duration of the fight. If he got knocked out, he would have to get knocked out. But that would have made a clear, you know, winner in his mind. You know, he gave Tyson Fury his props. He said the better man won tonight, but he felt like he should have went out on the shield. He was very upset with Mark Breland, and I feel like he should have been upset with Mark Breland for throwing in the towel. He asked him why he did it. First, he asked the referee because he thought Kenny Bayless did it. But Kenny Bayless immediately pointed to his corner and said, "Your corner stopped the fight, man." And he asked Mark, like, "Why did you do it?" You know, and Mark was like, "Man, because of your ears, man. Your ears is bleeding." I mean, Mark Breland is an excellent trainer, and he felt like he did what he had to do. But the thing about it is that I think he threw in a towel a little bit too fast. I don't think he was getting beat like that. He was still returning punches. If you look back at the fight and you look at the film, he was responsive to the attack of Fury. If he was unresponsive and stuff like that, and he wasn't throwing many punches or not trying to throw back or defend himself intelligently, he had his guards up. He was trying to partially block the punches. So I feel like he was very aware of what was going on, so it wasn't no point in throwing in no towel or stopping the fight at that point. I mean, could it have been that? Yeah, probably. I feel like Tyson Fury would have won the fight regardless. Don't get me wrong, but we don't really know that unless we see him do that. But see, for all the people who are saying, "Oh man, no man, that was the right decision," and you know, Wilder was hurt and he couldn't have done nothing about it, I beg to differ. I don't seen a lot of great champions do it before. Blood Boxing made a good point, man. We seen Larry Holmes come back and over again and do it. We seen Ali do it. We seen many great champions do it. And I put Deontay Wilder in the same category. I felt like he had an opportunity to have that moment himself, but it was taken away from him if he could have had done it. If he couldn't, he couldn't. But I would like to have seen if he could. Then we can make a better assessment on what Wilder is truly capable of as a champion. And maybe we'll get that opportunity in his next fight. Or hopefully he'll just continue to dominate like he's been dominating most of his career and knocking people out. But one thing for certain, two for sure, Tyson Fury won't be one of them guys that he's just going to run over. And now Fury has his respect. Now it's the new boxing king. And I don't want to hear nobody talking shit about him either, calling him feather-fisted and all this other dumb shit. You have to get a man his props. And that's where I'm at with that. And all you fake Wilder fans giving up on Wilder, trying to clown him on the low and all this bullshit, man, y'all whack and y'all fake. And my thing is this, man, and I always been saying this from the outset of this fight. You win or learn, you never lose. This is his first L in the loss column, yeah, but it's his only loss. And it may be his only L he'll ever take. But it's not really a loss, it's a learned experience. And a lot of people, you know, doubting Mark Breland's expertise. I would not do that as far as his training and his coaching. I felt like it was just stuff that Wilder neglected to do in this fight once again. I felt like he just didn't do what Breland wanted him to do in this fight. He probably thought that he can get right to it. The body attack was neglected once again in this fight. He should have went more to the body. He did not. He should be upset with Breland, but I don't agree with people calling for the man's job and all that shit. Breland shouldn't be fired, but should they bring in extra help? Absolutely. But I think, you know, it is what it is now. The fight is over. It was a great fight. It was better than the first fight. And I think those numbers were astronomical. They broke records as far as the live gate. And I think pay-per-view numbers is coming out soon. And I think the pay-per-view numbers are going to be pretty great as well. And especially for the third fight, I mean, golly, it's going to be awesome. And I do believe Wilder should go right into a rematch. Why not? He was the champ. I believe that he can go right into there and then regain his title. And thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Peace and blessings.
Thought I was dead. West Coast. I'm the doctor's advocate, homie Drake. Brought me back from the dead, that's why they call him the doctor. The math gon' drop.